simmering together and cooking.
Mm-hmm. It smells wonderful.
Once that gets done, then we will drain this and then add the chicken. This is a rotisserie chicken that I added mm-hmm. in here. I'm kind of tweaking this recipe.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
And then once we do that, we'll add the pasta. Prego.
It's own recipe.
Yeah.
Don't call out those people, Nina, because they're not going to send us a check.
No, they're not
sending us a check.
Your favorite tomato sauce.
Yes, my favorite.
Yes.
And then I also add some cheese. Mm-hmm. Salsa.
Yes.
Because it has black beans and corn mm-hmm. and different other things in there.
Okay.
So I add that. And then we're going to be putting some garlic.
Okay.
And then we're gonna lay all that over the zucchini boat.
Okay.
And then we're gonna top that with cheese.
My favorite.
Yes.
Yay, cheese.
Mexican five cheeses.
Okay.
And then we're gonna bake that for 30 minutes.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And then once that's done, then we will be able to eat because the coleslaw will be done.
Okay.
And the garlic bread will be done. And then we'll have a surprise for everybody. Got a little dessert.
Oh. Dessert. Okay.
So once we get this going, then I'll be back.
Okay. Sounds good.
Wonderful.
Well, in their 70s. Mm-hmm. And he said, well, yeah, they're the same age as my wife. And so I kind of faded to black with his rest of the conversation because I was stuck on him saying he was 60 and his wife was the same age as my dad. Mm-hmm. So and my dad is 78. So I heard nothing else he said. When I hung up with, and they've been married, by the way, for 25 years.
Wow.
So when you were saying that, I went right to them.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And I thought, well, they've been married for 25 years, and so he was in his 30s mm-hmm. when they met. Now, it may also depend on how old you are when you get married.
Yeah, that's true.
Because maybe if you're a man in his 30s is probably at the point where he's about ready to settle down
in.
Now, a man in his 20s.
Yeah.
And marrying a woman who's 37,
yeah,
that's kind of a different,
yeah,
you know, a different yeah. era. But I mean, I think I don't see why it couldn't work.
And then I guess also too, with them being married for so long, they had built a relationship,
right?
You know, so if somebody's getting older, you've had a relationship with someone. Right. That's what I tell people all the time. You know, people who like single people. You know, at some point you're going to get older, and if you do want to get married to someone, you know, if you do want to get married.
Mm-hmm.
It's good to get married so you at least have a few years.
Good years. Everybody's healthy.
Right, while everybody's healthy, because if somebody gets sick,
right,
and we might have only been married a year or so, I might not like you that much.
That's the danger.
Depending.
Younger women, say if I'm single
mm-hmm.
and I'm 52 years old,
mm-hmm.
then I go and date somebody that's 32.
Mm-hmm. mm-hmm.
To me, our mindset and where we are emotionally is different.
Right.
You know, the things we like to do with might possibly different.
Mm-hmm.
And then a year later, I get sick.
Mm-hmm.
Are you going to be mature enough
right.
mm-hmm.
to take care of me?
Somebody mm-hmm. in your 20s. So I mean, that's a heavy burden.
That's a burden. Could mm-hmm. be a burden.
Mm-hmm. But, you know, I think also to that point, Nina, then it could also depend on what type of life they've had. Maybe they've been married already before. You know, they were married for 5 or 10 years. So they know what that looks like
yeah.
already. So he may be at the same place as you in his 30s where, you know, he's not just coming out the club, you know, where he has been settled in and, you know, and I like
but
that.
But she's
not
in her 20s.
Yeah, but then just make sure he ain't looking for a mama. I'm going to go back to the food.
Right, right, right. That's true, too.
Yeah, because if he's looking for a mama, ew.
Right, that's true.
Well, that's true, too.
Soon as it gets hard for you, or you
right.
start dealing,
that's true.
You start growing into where you are in
right.
your age bracket.
Right. Okay. Yeah. That's true. That's true. But I think it just, I mean, that's a.
Well, I think it could work, but I think being married to someone for 25 years is different than just meeting someone.
Sure.
Especially somebody very, very, you know, 10 or 15 years younger.
Right.
5 years, I don't really consider that, you know, older or younger or
right.
whatever.
Right.
But you know, getting to the
17 10. Yeah, he had 17 was his wife was 17 years older than he is. 17
wow,
years.
That's a lot.
17?
That's a lot of years.
I mean, I'm telling you, when he was talking to me, I didn't hear nothing else he said. I was 17 because I'm counting, you know, is that 17 years? You know, but good for them.
Exactly.
You know, good, and he loves her.
Well, they built a, you know, they have a relationship. Yeah, they built a relationship. History. You know what I mean? So
that makes a
if she got sick or he got sick or whomever,
right,
they've had some history.
Right.
But you're just marrying somebody now at 52, and if he's an older husband, he's, you know, 75. Mm-hmm. You know, and he gets sick, and, you know, you all haven't had that much history together. Mm-hmm. So it depends on...
Okay, I'm going to add the chicken now.
Uh-oh. Oh, we have, it's a three meat dish.
Yeah.
That's going to
be hearty.
Sure.
Really hearty.
I'm going to add the salsa.
Miss Nina, you can create a dish.
And you hear me? She act like mom.
My favorite
That's okay. We just family having a conversation.
Exactly.
And cooking.
And cooking.
Oops, so long. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna let this simmer. I'm gonna add my garlic and a little balsamic vinegar.
Okay. Oh, listen, Miss Lady. We said you love balsamic vinegar.
No, we're gonna take your balsamic vinegar tasting.
Yes.
Because you know we go to a restaurant, I don't do the butter.
No, you do balsamic, please.
I'm good with that.
I'm still stuck on butter.
Just a little garlic. Now, I still haven't mastered the mincing yet, but I will, Miss Tina.
The mincing?
Yeah, the garlic, the real garlic.
Oh, Well, well that's okay. Yeah, they make it like
step
that.
Step at a time.
Yeah, they make it like that so we can use it.
So now we're going to let this simmer.
Okay. You're spreading it over the dish.
Each bowl.
Oh, okay.
Oh, okay. To that point, when we were talking about younger men and older women, so I heard this, I saw this research that was done, and it said, and tell me what you guys think about this. It said that 66% of the men that were polled said that they use excuses to get out of sex. Do you all believe that? 66% of men.
It didn't say anything about age.
No. 66% of men in society use excuses to get out of sex.
I don't know about that one. I guess I just never would have thought about that one.
Yeah. Well, it was interesting because, you know, you never think of men having excuses for, you know,
right,
for being intimate. And so when they said it, I was thinking, I don't believe that. But I mean... You know, they have no reason to lie.
Right.
But I thought that was an interesting comment, though.
I know.
66%?
Producer, you have anything to say about that?
You remain mute.
You will remain mute.
But maybe
when they marry you...
They have excuses?
Yeah, they have excuses.
So maybe this is married men.
Yeah, there probably is.
Maybe this
because
one.
They, you know,
every
life kicks in.
That's true.
Yeah. They get comfortable because, right. I mean, can I just be real?
Yeah.
Because yes. It's there.
Yeah.
You know, and then they get caught up in work and all the social stuff. And
right.
Before you know it, it's been 2 weeks.
Right. Research with.
Yeah, that would be good to know.
Yeah.
Who was actually the person who they polled?
The population. Yeah, that was very interesting to me though. And you can watch our show, Bay Area Cooking and Conversations, on Saturdays and with all this hair. Or Comcast Channel 27 or AT&T UVerse Channel 99 in the city of Vallejo. Or all over the Bay Area. Make sure you check us out.
Also, too, if you'd like to support the show, we want to make sure we stay on the air. Always good entertainment. Please contact us at Drake Entertainment. That's Drake Entertainment at yahoo.com. Again, if you'd like to support the show, help us keep us on the air. We don't have commercials. We're not doing commercials for this, that, or the other. We are it. And so if you'd like to support us, we'd be happy for your contribution. And that's Drake Entertainment at yahoo.com.
Now we're ready to put the meat sauce. Doesn't that look good?
Mm-hmm. So I'm feeling like it's a little healthy because you got the zucchini bowl. I feel good about that. I like that.
Well, this, the recipe, there's other recipes out there that are probably a lot more healthier because they don't have the chicken. I added the chicken and the pasta.
Chicken's good.
I thought this would be a little party for
you. Have pasta in there?
No. Oh. There's other recipes.
Okay.
There's other recipes that don't call for the
pasta
sauce.
Oh, okay, I see.
That's going to be nice, though, with the zucchini nice and tender, and then that's going to be really good.
So, your recipe, how many zucchini boats do you make?
I made six.
Okay.
Because this is a 13 by 9 grill dish. So, I took six and cut them in.
Twelve boats.
So you slice the zucchinis in half,
I slice the zucchinis, and then you just take the middle out.
Okay.
So that they'll kind of, so they'll cook into the
zucchini. Uh-huh.
To make the boat.
Right.
Yeah. That's gonna be nice.
Now we're going to.
And so just like half a pound of ground beef, half a pound of.
Yes.
Ground turkey, and then like half a pound of rotisserie chicken or just chicken?
Well, what I did was I just took a whole rotisserie chicken and then just deboned it.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Now we're going to take the, and then on the bottom of the, before I put the meat sauce in, I put Parmesan cheese.
Okay.
On the bottom.
Oh.
So now we're doing the, we're going to let this cook for 30, about 25 minutes, and then we'll take it out and put the cheese on and let the cheese melt.
Okay.
So now we're. Be back in 5 days. Now I'm putting together a little dessert. It's it's croissants and peaches. So we call this like really peach cobbler, but on the quick side. So we're going to take our crescent roll. And what I did was I just laid it on top of some foil with a little flour. So you can easily remove them. And just take a couple peaches. Now, if you'd like to, so we're just gonna have little canned peaches. It tastes really good. We're gonna lay them in here, and then we're gonna roll them. And then once I get this going, then I'll let you see how I add in the vanilla, cinnamon, and then my co-hosts were like, "What are you doing with that? Mountain Dew."
A recipe with Mountain Dew.
Yes.
I think that's a first for me.
Me too.
And we're gonna they also have other recipes that you can use cake mix. And then 7-Up.
Right.
And dry cake mix. And then the 7-Up causes it to rise.
Right.
You put it in the oven.
Yeah, because I know when I make my 7-Up cake, you don't put any leavening agent. The 7-Up acts as a leavening agent. No, that's a quick, fast, and a hurry dessert.
Then we're gonna
whatever leavening means. What does leavening mean?
Vanilla ice cream.
Rice.
On the side.
Gonna have what?
Homemade vanilla ice cream.
No.
You made ice cream?
No.
pretend homemade.
The brand name is homemade.
Girl. My mother used to make the best homemade ice cream for our birthday. She always made homemade ice cream.
Oh, yes. That was the best. When you had to turn the thing yourself.
Yes,
then we got fancy and got the electric ones.
With the rock salt.
Wow. Oh my goodness. There was nothing like homemade ice cream. Talk about childhood memories.
Yes.
Wow.
So ladies, we were going to talk about there's an issue that it kind of concerns me as well. Pastors who do
counseling.
Marital counseling.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just kind of, you know, please write us and give us your feedback and comments on this too. And you can write us at BayAreaCooking@yahoo.com. So I guess the conversation is, do you think that pastors should do counseling if they're not certified as counselors?
Right. Yeah. You know, and I don't know, I've never been to theology school, so maybe as part of theology school, maybe they do have some counseling courses or what have you, but certainly when you're counseling someone having to do with their lives, you know, are you offering an opinion? Are you counseling? You know, which one is it? But, you know, certainly things that affect people's lives. I think, and not to say that some pastors are not good at this or have experience in terms of schooling or whatever in it, but I just think that when you, when you're approaching anyone having to do something life-changing, you should have some...
Degree of training.
Yeah, I think so. Some type of degree of training.
Nina,
Christina, what were you saying?
So now we're just going to
butter.
Lord.
Paula D.
Lord.
It's got you bathing it in butter?
Drenched.
A butter bath.
And then we have some vanilla.
Whoa. Nina, where do you get these recipes at?
Google it. And then we have some cinnamon.
Whoa.
Now here we go for you. This is going to make it rise because the Mountain Dew.
Wow.
Now this was a hit for my family in San Francisco for Christmas.
Whoa.
Now you know me and my add some to everything. I probably would put some walnuts on it. Doing too much.
Yeah, exactly.
Doing too much. That looks wonderful, though. Wow.
Oh, I'm going to add a little more cinnamon on each one.
Yeah. So you've made this before?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I found it last Christmas. Now, we've got about 3 more minutes, and then we will take out the boat.
Okay.
Got a little surprise for you ladies.
Okay.
We'll take the boats out.
The pastor and the counselor.
No, my pastor, he straight told us, he said, I don't have a degree in marital counseling. That's why I have a paid staff.
Right.
That's professionally, they might be members of our congregation, but they are professionally degreed in the area of family and marital
counseling.
So that makes me feel comfortable.
Right.
You know, because pastors, they get busy.
They do.
The cares of life and trying to help you with your life.
And hearing all those people's problems.
Yeah. Right. So, and then they got their own stuff.
Right. Families and problems.
You know, it's better to, and counseling really is a good thing.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Counseling is a good thing.
It's just a good thing.
Yeah.
From a professional.
That's a good point. You know, like I said, if there are pastors watching, we would love some feedback and your opinions on this. Again, catch us at BayAreaCooking@yahoo.com. And also, if you're looking for the recipes of today or any of the other shows, again, reach out to us at BayAreaCooking.com.
Also, too, you can watch this show on Saturdays and Wednesdays at 10 a.m. You can also catch us on the web, and that's at www.vcat.tv or Comcast Channel 27 or AT&T Uverse Channel 99 in Vallejo. So we have all kinds of access. And so if you don't live in Vallejo, again, you can catch us on the web. And that's on Saturdays and Wednesdays. Now, someone called me, one of my friends, about 3:30 in the morning. They sent me a text message about 3:30 in the morning. So even though we say the show is on Saturdays and Wednesdays at 10 a.m., I guess they repeat shows. Mm-hmm. They come on all times of night. So if you're one of those late night owls, you're able to catch the show at some time.
And tell your friends too. If you do live in Vallejo, you have friends who live in the Bay Area, they can catch us too on their local access TV as well. So make sure you tell your friends to check us out. We'd love to have you check us out. Yeah.
And spread some joy.
We're going to take out.
Hold on. The glasses.
The glasses. Yeah.
I wear lashes. Love my lashes. That's what I'm trying to say.
So The newest accessory in the kitchen for all you divas is the goggles.
Is the goggles.
To save your lashes.
To save your lashes. Good idea.
I love it. Oh, it smells wonderful.
One, two, three. Take this off. Now we're going to add our cheese on top.
Oh, Nina, you got the butter.
Cheese.
Cheese.
I'm not the healthy cook in this.
Well, this is the splurge day. Back to your challenges on Monday.
Yes.
Well, we did walk today.
We did walk. We did. Oh, our Haiti mission had a walk-a-thon, and
yes,
we did walk.
We did walk today.
We did walk today.
This up, and then we'll finish our conversation.
A little blurb too. This wasn't even part of our conversation, but you know, about life insurance, we have to really, really think about that. Even young people, if you have children, older people, you have spouses, and you know, even single people, think about your future, or more importantly, think about those people who are going to have to take care of the things. Sometimes problems that you've left, and make sure it's not accidental insurance, because you might not die of an accident.
Exactly.
You know, make sure you get a little bit of coverage so that people can take you. Children have something. Your spouse is not out of resources,
yeah.
Out of their home or what have you. Even just single people, that somebody can take care of your business when you're gone, because we all gonna leave something.
Right.
Some people are gonna have to take care of. So make sure you get yourselves a little bit of life insurance.
Yeah, and even just, you know, even if it's just enough that will help the person who's remaining to bury you. You know, because even burials, though, I mean, even something, the bare minimum, you know, cremation is $3,000
right.
Or whatever. You know, so just, you know, and make it so that whoever is left, because I've heard some people say, well, it won't matter to me because I'll be gone. Well, it should matter, because you shouldn't
right.
leave somebody in debt.
Right.
Or somebody struggling to take care of the thing that you should have taken care of.
Yes.
So, yeah, please get some life insurance. You know, find you a, you know, somebody you trust, and especially if you drive an automobile, you should have automobile insurance.
Right, that's true.
Ask that automobile broker about life insurance. I'm sure they'll be able to help you out. And make sure you ask them the difference between term and whole.
Yes.
Because those are different. You want to make sure I don't know the difference. I forgot what it is. But, you know, just speak to somebody, but make sure
a professional.
A professional.
Just like your counseling, make sure that's a professional. Make sure
Bingo.
Your life insurance is professional,
professional
as well.
Bingo. Exactly.
Well, you also want a living trust.
Living trust. Yeah.
So nobody's
really
arguing
important.
About that, because
right.
we had a situation in our family. We went on for like 6 years. So
yeah.
Make sure nobody's arguing about the money
yes.
that didn't belong to them.
Anyway.
Yeah.
From day one.
Yeah. Make sure you get all that taken care of.
Well, this is a meal that's
yes,
been placed in
front
of
us.
Talk about staying in your lane.
Amen.
You stayed in your lane on today. This looks wonderful.
I'm going to try this.
Everything looks
good. Lord bless the food and the cook.
Amen. Ooh, and the zucchini's so tender. Now, how long did everything have to cook?
I left it in there for 30 minutes, and then I just put the cheese for like 5 minutes.
Excellent. Hot. Very good.
Really good.
And kind of simple, too.
We're going to dine a little bit, and we're going to come back with the dessert, and we'll end the show. And see you in about 9 sufficient.
Oh, yes, we have.
Wonderful meal.
Yes.
Was that wonderful?
Oh, beautiful.
Fantastic.
Wonderful.
Was good.
Really good job.
It was really good.
And the key to that recipe was, had we not had to do all this, you know, the talking and this being a show, ladies, you can come in and work that out about 30, 45 minutes.
That's great.
Now we have a little dessert.
That looks really good.
Doesn't that look good for
yes.
like 10 minutes?
Yes.
Like 5 minutes of work.
Keep a can of peaches in your cabinet.
Yes. Truth be told, I forgot the peaches. But I had a can of peaches in the cabinet. And we're just going to taste this real quick here.
It's your homemade ice cream.
Homemade vanilla ice cream. The parents used to make me. So good.
You can say so yourself.
Yes. Thanksgiving to everyone. We hope you had a good time watching us. We look forward to coming back during those Christmas holidays when you got to get that Christmas dinner together. But enjoy. forward to seeing you again.
And we'll talk about our all-time favorite, the holiday party. Your holiday party etiquette.
Yes, yes, definitely.
Bye-bye. See you later.
Well, I'll see you next time.
Thank you for your support.
Happy Thanksgiving.